So there were a few things that you should remember that I told you guys are very important about resonant structures. First of all, remember that we use curved arrows. Easy. Okay, remember that we use brackets with little double-sided arrows to link structures. But also remember that we always start from the area of highest electron density and work our way to the areas of less density. So in that case, that has to be the nitrogen, because the nitrogen has a full negative charge on it. That means that is the most negative thing. So what I want to do here is I want to try to move those electrons. The only way that I can move them is by becoming a double bond, okay? So or becoming a pi bond, I'm sorry. So if these electrons move down here and became a pi bond, that would be great, except I have a problem. If I did that, then this carbon would have five electrons on it, okay, or five bonds, okay? So five bonds is terrible. That would break the octet rule. It would be 10 electrons, by the way. I'm sorry, not five. 10 electrons would break the octet rule. So if I make that bond, what do I have to do? Do you guys remember? I have to break a bond, okay? Why did I draw it at the bottom? You could have drawn it at the top too. But if you make a bond, you have to break a bond. And this is that pattern that I told you guys that, oops, that was weird, that anions come with two arrows. Okay? And the reason is because anytime you're making that new double bond, you're gonna have to break a bond as well, or a new pi bond, okay? So what that's gonna do is it's gonna give me a structure that looks like this, where now I have N with a triple bond, carbon, and then an oxygen. Now, nitrogen already gave up one of its lone pairs to become a triple bond, so that means it only has one pair, lone pair left. Carbon has the same amount of electrons as before, it's just they're arranged a little differently. And then oxygen has one additional lone pair because the electrons from that double bond became a lone pair. So basically, the additional lone pair is this red one, and that red one came from this bond over here breaking. Does that make sense? Cool. So now we have to do formal charges. So I would have, it's funny that I put my negative there, I actually would have a negative right here on the O. And then would I have any other charges that I have to worry about? No, the carbon is fine, and the N is fine. So really, that's it. I just got my resonance structure, okay? Are there any other things that we could do? Not really, because if I make this negative, let's say that I go back and put this negative back here, once again, I'm gonna have to break a bond. So what that means is that these two resonance structures are going to be basically two different versions of the way this molecule could look, but that's it. That's the only thing that it can do. So I'm gonna put brackets around this, and that's gonna be a wrap, okay? That's gonna be the end of that problem.